Hello, this is Javad Hamidi. Today I'm going to teach you how to use conditional formatting in Revit. Don't forget to subscribe us for more videos and also turn on the notification button to be the first person who will notice our new videos. And you can ask your questions and suggestions for future videos in the comment section too. Okay, let's open Revit. Let's talk about the conditional formatting. Conditional formatting is type of conditions that you can use in scheduling for separating specific kind of data from all of the data. It can be used, for example, for floor areas and for all kind of data you can imagine. But now I'm gonna test it on a floor plan area in different concepts for a building that will help me to find a best form for my concept. So let's start to create a new project. Click here. I'm gonna use metric architectural template. Okay. Go to massing and site tab. Click on create in place mass. Okay. The name is not matcher here, but I'm gonna name it maybe form one. Because we want to create three form and compare them in conditional format. Form one. Okay. Let's go to 3D. Let's go to top view. Let's create a rectangle here. I'm gonna create a rectangle here with the size of 5 to 5 meters. Press tab, 5 meter, and 5 meter for this side too. Okay, that's nice for me. Okay, select the rectangle and click on create form. The height would be maybe 20 meters. Okay, finish mass and okay. I'm gonna create some additional levels to create a massing floor. Okay, I'll go to the north and create new levels. You can change it to maybe 4 is good, 4 is good. And I'm gonna create some levels above. Okay, go to the architectural tab, click on level, maybe 4 meter offset would be a good offset here. Okay, and okay, this is good. I don't need this, so I'll delete that. Delete this. Okay, I go to the 3D. And I'm gonna start to create massing floors. Select the form, form one, and click on mass floors. Select the select all of the levels to create floors for them. Okay. Okay, these are the floors that I need. Okay, this is good. Okay, but before that, I'm gonna specify the usage of each floor to each floor, and in the end of the video, we can compare the form in comparison with our goals for the usage of floor plan area. Okay, for example, the first one. Usage would be commercial. I use abbreviation here. Okay, commercial. This and this would be commercial two. And these two, I'm gonna make them residential or RES. Okay, I'm gonna copy two another forms from the original form to compare them after some modification to get. Okay, select this, press CO for copy, multiple, and copy to another forms here. Select this, and you can you don't need that. Okay, we go to the invoice mask to do some modification to this form. For example, I'm gonna select this point and bring it down to see the difference. Okay, and for the third one too. I'm gonna bring it in from this side and from this side too. Okay, this is my third four. Click on finish and let's create a schedule for this floor area. Go to the view tab, click on schedule, schedule quantities, and search for mass here, mass. And specifically mass floor. Okay, I need floor area, I need level, I need mass family and type to separate these three. Okay, bring mass family and type upper. Okay, it's good. Gloria, calm down. Let's see, and we need usage too. Usage can be a second call. This is ideal for me, so click on OK, and our schedule will be created here. But we need some modification here to have conditional format. Select all of them. Align, center, align, center. Okay, first of all, I'm gonna separate them with mass, family, and type. For that, you can go to the fields, click on sorting and grouping, sort by mass, family, and type. You can put a header too, and blank line after. Okay. It will separate my form from another. Okay, but I'm gonna see the difference between schedule and real time reaction of the schedule for the form. So I'm gonna open 3D and schedule to good. For that, you can press W and T. In 3D, of course, and see the forms and schedule together. When you select one of them, you can see the floors here to recognize the forms that you are changing. Okay, my conditional format would be the minimum area for commercial. So I need 25 meter. Commercial area for each floor. So we want to assign a conditional format that would red mark all of the commercial floor areas under 25 meters. So let's do that. Go to the schedule and. It's not a big difference and doesn't matter which one you click because the destination of all of them are same. Okay, formatting. I go to the formatting. You should go to the formatting tab, and after that, you should choose the column that you want to the conditional formats for that For example, I'm as I said earlier, I want to do some modification and some rules for floor area. So I go to the floor area and I choose conditional format here. I say field floor area to changing the color. I want to change the color of floor area for the floor areas that are below 25 meter area. Okay, floor area is good. Test. It should be less than 25. But let's change the color of background to red. And okay. You can see we have different floors that doesn't satisfy our goals. So we can change our form to satisfy our goal. To do that, for example, for our form 3, this form, we can change our form to satisfy our goals. Select the form, click on edit in place, and let's make it bigger to satisfy our goals. Okay, bring it here and bring it here. Select this, click on a space for changing the UCS. Okay, I'm gonna move it here. And that's good. Okay, click on finish, and you can see our goals now satisfied. So it's not it can be a good analysis for your first form creation, and you can check your numbers and additional information here.